ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to WCEF No Limits. Tonight, we get an update on Ace's Do or Die 3 farewell status. And then, we have Eli James going one-on-one against the reborn Mr. Reality. And then right after that, we hear from the new assignee, Mr. Anthony Killer Cali. And let's see what he has to say about the OAV Championship and High Fire. And then, a face-to-face, the WCEF Do or Die 3 main event, Slayer, Apollo Blade. Let's get this show on the road.
So, sad news. Doc said I tore my labrum. And I'm gonna be out for the rest of the WCEF shit. And it's heartbreaking, you know? Do or Die season, it's never been for me. Do or Die won, I lost to Apollo. Global championship match, I blew it. Do or Die 2, death match between me and Red X Dark. I blew it. But I cashed in. That was a plus. And now Do or Die 3, farewell. I guess my farewell is coming a lot sooner than I hoped. But I guess I'll just say my goodbyes now. Psych! No. I'm not gonna give up. You all know Ace, my mentality. I'm not gonna let my doctor just say, no, you can't do this, you can't do that. That is impossible for you to do. There have been many things that have been conquered, and I'm gonna conquer this. And I will do whatever it takes to face Red X Dark for a rematch for the Extreme Championship. I'll do whatever it takes. I will kill myself before I can give up. You better believe it.
Hello, WCEF. My name is Mona Lott, and I'm here with Eli James.
Hey, honey. Where have you been? When did you get so tall?
I've always been this tall. So,
what?
Why did you call me honey? Just now.
What do you mean? We had a thing going.
Not anymore.
What?
Hold on. What the hell do you think you're doing, Eli? Are you trying to flirt with my girl or what?
Aren't you gay?
Nah. If I was gay, would I do this? Come on, don't flirt with my girl.
Sorry, I just threw up a little bit in my mouth. What? Your girl?
Yeah.
That's my girl.
Nah.
We were thinking, but
maybe you thought that, but now it's time for you to back off.
No, it's my girl.
Nah, you got it wrong, man. Oh, you knocked out my fucking kid. Okay. You really want to go? You really want to see whose girl this is? I'll see you outside. Yeah.
All right.
Well, goddamn. In a backstage interview with Mona Lott, Mr. Reality and Eli James got into a bit of an altercation of who has the right to be with Miss Mona Lott.
Yeah.
Eli believing that his history with her at Breakout makes him entitled to being with her. Reality having some thoughts about that. You know, sometimes wrestling isn't that hard. Two guys don't like each other, fuck it, throw them in the ring. This'll be interesting.
She's mine. That gay boy's in an illusion.
Goddamn. I personally, this is gonna be a little bit of an. It's gonna be an interesting match, to say the least.
Your wish is in the
crisis. Nobody crisis. I never thought I'd see the day that WCEF got a power couple. But here we are, I guess. Oh, look at Mr. Reality. Being chivalrous and bringing Miss Mona Lott a seat. Oh boy. Oh boy. Oh God. Watch it. Bell rings, this contest is official, and Mr. Reality out of the gates with a drop kick. Waist lock, might be going for that German, Jesus, the height. One, two, kick out at two, very early two count. Eli must not have expected that. That was a very early two count in the beginning of this match. Eli pushing off Reality. Oh, big boot. And a drop kick of his own. Oh, and Reality's back up. Oh, kick to the side. Oh God, the patriotic kicks. Yes. Yes. Oh boy. Oh fuck. Well, I guess Eli dedicating that last kick to Miss Mona Lott, but the senton onto the back of Reality, that might take some of the power away. Rolling senton. Oh, and Reality gets out of it. Oh my God, one, two, kick out at two by Eli. I don't even know what that is, but it was effective. Reality's got control of the wrist, brings it down, that joint manipulation. Take away that discus forearm. Take away the finish of Eli James, can't hit that. And look at the grapple. Look at the grappling by Mr. Reality. Upping his game, and hey, that's a rope break. One, two, three, four. Come on, get off of him, get off of him. The grappling, the overall wrestling of Mr. Reality has seen a drastic increase since aligning him, since the breakup of the Gay Lads. I'm going to be honest with you, ladies and gentlemen. I don't like this side of Mr. Reality, but one cannot deny that he has gotten significantly better. Oh, God, there's that side headlock choking the air out of Eli James's. Oh, and he's choking him with his own arm now. Both of them. You want to give up, Eli? Oh, there's a code breaker. High stack. One, two. Kick out at two by Eli James. Oh, and a donkey kick catches Reality in the air. Kip up. Oh, and Zagiri of his own. Eli rolls through. Might be trying to gain some distance for something big. And Reality, another drop kick puts one third of the fucking Patriots down. Reality now just laying down the strikes. You know, funnily enough, what a spine buster. Funnily enough, this. Seeing this side of
Reality. What we had. We had something special. He stood all the way for some.
I'm not an. Okay. I'm not commenting on that. I don't know if we can say that. God. Eli's a little pissed off. You know, I know the guy personally. He's never been this much of a dick, but I guess when you. Oh my God! Angle slam! Well, from one American hero to another, Eli James emulating the man that won the Olympics with a broken freaking neck, and Eli DDTing Mr. Reality so hard he came out of his do-rag. Oh, Pele kick! Reality catches Eli with the Pele kick. I don't think he knows where he is. Kicks of the hamstrings, might be trying to cramp him up. Splash! One, two, kick out at two by Eli. Whoa. You know, seeing this side of reality isn't surprising. You all got to remember, at one point, Mr. Reality was the extreme champion, so we know he's got an aggressive side in him.
Don't let him go.
Hey, get off the ropes. Get off the ropes. Reality trying to use the rope, the springs, the ropes, whatever you want to call it, trying to use them as leverage. Hammer locks the arm, and he's trapped it. Has no way of defending himself, and he's laying down those huge shots to the back. The bulletproof back of Eli James. Reality with a diving double foot stomp to the back of Eli. Cover. One, two. Kick out at two by Eli. Now, what will Reality do to put down Eli James at this point? He still has the reality check in his arsenal. He has yet to hit that. So at some point, oh, there's the stomp. Good night, Eli. Good night. Eli is actually out cold. This might cost Reality a little bit. Cover. One, two. Oh, and a kick out by Eli. See those moments of Eli being dead weight cost him. It gave him recovery time. But that curb stomp definitely put Eli out for the count momentarily. Eli, monkey flip, puts Reality on his back. Discus clothesline! Ball game! One, two, kick out at two! Reality kicked out of the discus lariat. That's got to be demoralizing for Eli James. What else can he do? He just hit his home run strike, and Reality fought out of it. That's got to be demoralizing. What else can he do? There's a super kick right on the chin. Oh, my God. And Reality doesn't feel it, and he's gone back to the well. Another hit. Another dance. European. Yeah. What's he got left? Strikes, back and forth hits. Oh, and there's the uppercut. Reality has to be closing on the finish of this match. He's got Eli on the ropes. There we go, locks it in. Reality check. Cover, count, one, two, three. Ball game. A sickening reality for Eli James. Grudge match lost. That's got to be, that has to have impressed Miss Mona a lot. WCEF's power couple is getting better and better by the day. Now, what does Ada have to be thinking about this? Well, holy shit, ladies and gentlemen. Like I said when he first showed up, I never thought I would see the day that Anthony Killer Cali shows up in WCEF.
Back again. Cali's here.
Well, the West Coast Killer is here.
WCEF. Yours truly, AKC, Anthony Cali in the flesh. And see, last time I was here, I extended my hand out to a high flyer. I extended out my hand and I told him at Do or Die 3, high flyer versus Anthony Cali, Anthony Killer Cali, for that OAB Network Championship, for that belt. And what do you do? He spit in my face. He said no. See, High Flyer, I beat you. I beat you in the middle of that ring at Grand Prix. One, two, three. See, you and I, we go back and forth all in EBW. But have yet to have a match with you and WCEF. So I figured, why not? Why not at the Do or Die 3 farewell? Why not AKC versus High Flyer for that belt? But no, you spin in my face, you walk away, and you're scared. You tucked your tail between your legs and you walked out. But that's fine. That's damn fine, because I know that I could beat your ass here, I could beat your ass in EBW. See, history will repeat itself. And when it repeats itself, I'm gonna take away that belt and add it to my collection. Add it and take it home to California. High Flyer, you may have spit in my face, may have not shook my hand, but you and I know damn well we can give it all, everything we got, 110%, and show that I can go anywhere and be a belt collector. So I'm waiting for your response, High Flyer. I'm waiting.
Well, I guess Anthony Killer Cali said his piece, and he's, I guess, debating on what to do now, whether he's... Oh, and High Flyer from behind!
There you go. Hold those for me.
Yes, sir.
While I beat his ass.
Okay. Oh, fuck's sake.
Want another one?
Sure.
Me too. Oh.
Sorry, Cali, but I'm biased towards my boys, even though he's a massive prick.
Come here, you stupid... bald-headed ass.
Oh, shit.
Well, Cali. You called me out once again. That was your first mistake. Your next mistake was thinking that you could book the matches. No, stay down.
Oh, shit.
Now, your third mistake... is actually wanting the match. Let me see, Cali. Let me tell you how it goes around here, okay? Because this ain't no little tea party like Breakout. This isn't no little sissy party like ESW, okay? I know your story, Cali. And in both companies, you were a nobody. And now you're about to hit your third and still be a nobody. So, Killer Cali. At Do or Die 3, farewell. The OAB Network Championship will be on the line with High Flyer defending it against none other than bum-ass Killer Cali. Now put your hand out, Cali. Put your hand out. Come on. Do what Daddy says, bitch, and put your hand out. You got it. Stupid looking fuck. I watch this shit. Hey, watch this shit real quick.
No way. If spitting in his face wasn't enough, here comes the ultimate disrespect. High Flyer lining Cali up. Boo, psycho knee!
So, Cali. You got the match. SWF OAB Network Championship. High Flyer, Killer Cali, Do or Die 3.
Cali made the challenge. High Flyer, metaphorically signing the contract. Color me impressed, because now High Flyer went from irrelevancy to history making in one 7-hour trip to SWF. At Do or Die 3 farewell, Anthony Killer Cali, High Flyer, OAB Network Championship. Give me that kingdom, give me that
Hello, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to No Limits. I feel like I say that every single time I'm commentating. Then again, Cleet Torres here. My umbrella man trying to shield me from that hot sun is elsewhere. But ladies and gentlemen, there is the man that came out victorious in his match, the Legion Triple Threat match, and will now face, face Slayer at Do or Die 3 Farewell in the main event with his right hand man Alpha. Ladies and gentlemen, the road to Do or Die still continue.
All right, I don't know if y'all still keep up with this company ever since, you know, my title was basically robbed from me, but I'm now back on the quest to put WCF right back on the right track. You see, there is a triple threat a couple weeks back. Me, Sean Morgan, my right-hand man, Alpha. Brutal match, but at the end of the day, when you're messing with the god of WCF, I'm gonna come out on top doing whatever it fucking takes. Best part is, I did it all by myself. So now, I just booked myself a ticket to Do or Die 3 Farewell, where I can finally fix what this company did wrong to me. See, Barron had no business putting me number one in the elimination match. But hell, it's impressive on how far I got, didn't I? Hell, I eliminated his ass. But nonetheless, because of people like him running this company, people like Mamba, I'm not the WCF champion. Now, I know damn well that title rightfully belongs in my right hand. But there's nothing wrong with a bit of adversity. Because the god of WCF comes out on top under pressure. Hell, like that triple threat. All by myself. Didn't need help from Alpha. Sean Morgan gave me, I guess, his best performance. But it was not nearly enough to book himself a ticket to Do or Die. So he can sit from the sidelines and regret his decision for betraying me and Alpha Legion. As I walk out of Do or Die 3, two-time and final WCEF World Champion. Simply down, just looking down at
me. Well, ladies and gentlemen, the man that Apollo Blade will face for the WCEF champion, the man himself, Slayer, who has been on an absolute tear ever since becoming the WCEF world champion. There he is, ladies and gentlemen. Like I've said in the past, that moniker, kick ass, ask questions later, it's no longer in effect. Slayer, this version of Slayer, is here to kill and keep his WCEF championship.
Hearing you in the back, you make me laugh. You make me laugh too much. You know why? Because you weren't even the one to face me at elimination. You know why? Because you got beat by your own henchman. Sean, I don't know if you remember him, you know, because you kind of forget about anyone that helps you. Because you say you're the almighty Apollo. I can do this. I can do that. I'm the best ever. Fuck no. What proved in elimination is you need help. you need help from different people to win. And I proved that I could win by myself at all costs, no matter who the fuck I'm going against. I can win by myself. And you know what? I also remember whenever y'all targeted me before warfare, because I was the biggest threat. I was that guy. I was gonna be the guy to dethrone you, him, and Sean. I don't care what the fuck y'all say. Oh, they're gonna beat me 3-on-1. I don't care. 3-on-1, 1-on-3, same difference. I'm that guy. You know what? We'll go with my accolade. Like, extreme champion, international, Apache King of the Ring winner. Oh, let me refresh you. Have you ever beat Red X Dark? Oh, I didn't think so. I didn't think so. You know, I did, because I'm that guy, like I said. And I did it by myself. Clean win. What did you do? Run away, main legion, become a little bitch. Yeah, that's what I thought. You can't do shit on your own. And frankly, you look like a bitch. You're actually built like a bitch. You know how I know? Because you got this fat ass over here to help you. To do all your little dirty work. You know, frankly, whenever y'all beat me up over there, whenever I was working out with Ace, I didn't care. You know why? Because I already knew I was going to come here sooner or later to hold this right in front of your fucking face. See this? Like this? That's what I fucking thought. You know, I don't like that they're giving you the chance to go up against me at Do or Die 3. You know.
Oh my. This is about to pick up.
Party we got here is star-studded. What, my invite get lost in the mail?
You want an invite? You had your chance, and you lost.
Oh, okay. Yeah, you're talking about the 2-on-1 handicap.
Oh,
my bad. The triple threat.
Yeah, I'm talking
match. I got you. See, here's the thing. Look back real quick. Let's remove all fog, smoke, and mirrors. My brother in Christ, I was kicking the shit out of you, dude. You were getting a mud hole stomped in you. Until he stepped in. And when I got on his ass, when I had him down on the ground, motionless, you stepped in. I'm fighting 2-on-1 here, man. That match was bullshit, but I still accepted it. Because I don't know how many chances I got left. That match was bullshit. You know it. You know it. You certainly know it. These cameramen know it. These people know it. These people that put their faith in me, that had their faith in you, that have their faith in you. And they knew I was screwed from the get-go. But I still came out. I still showed out. I still put the work on you. I still put the work on you. And I know you were watching. You can try and play hard all you want, but I know you were watching. Because like it or not, Slayer, I've been hit in the face by people that don't like me. I've been hit in the face by people that do like me. But only 3 people have ever hit me in the face, and I took it as a sign of respect. I know you were watching. But that's just consistent with Sean Morgan, right? Every time there's an opportunity, every time, what am I doing? I'm here showing out. I get screwed. EBW, world title match right there. Boom, broken rib. EBW again. Grand Prix, main event final. Boom, dislocated shoulder. Every single time I got an opportunity to show every single one of y'all why I'm the best. Undeniably the best. something happens. Whether that be you, or whether that be you not doing shit, sitting on your ass. And you know what, bro? I'm gonna back off, because I like you. I respect you. This got nothing to do with you. This shit, I can't blame you. But I tell you what, you don't want me one-on-one. You don't want me in this match. I know why. It's because the last time you and I went one-on-one, you lost. Because you weren't expecting what I bring to the table. That was the villain, my guy. That was my rookie few months. You lost to a guy that had been on the roster for 2 months, 3 months. And you were on the come up. And you lost to me. That's why you don't want this. That's why you don't want this triple threat. That's why you don't want the title on me. Because you, they know that if that is around my waist, you're not touching it. You're certainly not touching it. You got the best chance of touching it. So what's the deal? You want to go one-on-one again? You want me to put my soul right across your chin again?
See, I'm down to be one-on-one with you, Sean. Hell, I'm excited for the triple threat. Mr. Trace, we all know we got history. Now, you can talk about that one-on-one match. We can go to high stakes where you can say something happened, but let's face it, they're all just excuses, Sean, as to why you have not won the big gold belt just yet, if ever. Frankly, something always happens, right? Something always happens to Sean Morgan. The same shit used to happen to Apollo Blade. But I was tired of sitting around trying to play what you would call fair. I took advantage of every opportunity I got. I made a difference. I won the global title. I won high stakes. I won elimination. I won the WCEF championship. If you really want that belt, you'll do whatever it takes.
Let's put an asterisk by my selfish shit. Global title. Now, I may not have been here when you won that, but shit, I got the internet. You made Otto sign a contract he didn't know was a contract. And after he fought tooth and nail, bled, spat, hell, cried, right here. After he earned that title, what you do? You come out, take off your hoodie, your sunglasses, and oh, Otto, congratulations on your first defense. After what, 20 minutes? Getting his ass kicked. Finally won. One of the big ones. And you gotta come and weasel your way into the match. But that's all you do, right? All you do is weasel. All you do is talk. You talked your way into the doors in WCEF. You talked your way into the global title. You talked your way into the world title. And allow me to elaborate on that one, because without that, he wouldn't be here. And he's only here because you manipulated him. Because you talked your way into it. I don't know if you remember, this was the second video ever on this channel. Ever. He's a world champion in his own right. But you don't respect him like that. You don't treat him like a world champion. You treat him like a fucking puppet. Because you know, without him, without me, without Legion, I wouldn't have been anywhere near you. You'd have been stuck in the deep trenches of the mid-card. Hell, we could have had our feud already. We could have had our fight. That could have been over, that beautiful white silver. But here you go. Talk. Oh, I can make you great. I can make you alpha. And what has he done since then? Tag team champion with me? Carry my unconscious body? Whisper in my ear? Blow smoke up my ass? Make me hear exactly what I want to hear? Tag team champion. Alpha, I fought you, man. I fought with you. I fought against you in the tag team tournament way back when. I fought with you in Legion. I can tell you right now, he'd be a better world champion than you. Your damn subordinate would be a better world champion than you. But no, talk. Smoke up the ass. Because without me, without him, you lost that title the first week you held it. You can't hang. You will never, never admit it, but you can't hang. You can't beat him one-on-one. Certainly can't beat him one-on-one. And let me tell you something, if you think you can beat me one-on-one, you're fucking dreaming. You can keep talking. Keep talking. He wants his rematch clause. You gonna give it to him? No, the fuck you aren't. Because I know you're smarter than that. I know the second that bell rings, you know he's gonna try and do some shit. You're not getting your rematch clause, my friend. No. See, I think I'd rather die than have to watch that. So I'll tell you what. This match happens. Guess what? I'm clocking your buddy. And I'm punching you dead across your damn jaw.
Getting a little too close there. You know, if you knew better, you know to stay away from him. Like you said, this bad shit, he'll come and beat you up. Straight up. So you know what? I'm not usually the type to do this, but you literally remind me of myself when I first started, just trying to find your way in this business, find any opportunity. So I'm gonna give you one chance. One chance to make it into the main event. And that's if you beat one of these two. And that's their choice.
So, my tag team partner, we're 2-0 over here.
Yes.
Like I said, you don't want me one-on-one. I know you don't. Whether you like to admit it or not, I'm still right there in your heart. I know you still give a shit about me. So neither of you want to fight me. We already saw what happened when we were all in this ring. Smoke up the ass. Me. You know.
Wait. Before you say anything, before any of this goes on, there's one condition. If you lose, you're gone out of this company. Frankly, I don't give a shit if you're here or anywhere else, but you just gotta win just to get your opportunity. I'm just here for chances, and I'm giving you one. Either here or the highway. So, ladies and gentlemen, let me introduce you the match of the century, Sean Morgan versus Badass over here, to enter the main event of Do or Die 3 Farewell. Y'all watching this, right?
Got a deal.
Oh, Jesus Christ, an Apollo bleed. Well, I guess Sean was right. He wasn't gonna. Sean Morgan over here. Oh my God, his legs are talking. And oh my God, you got Sean in Alpha. After the chaos going on. Oh my God, Slayer. Oh my goodness, Alpha. Oh my God, Slayer. Oh my God. Oh Jesus, forearm. Oh my God. And again, you got Morgan. Oh, I felt that kick. It's too bad it was caught. Jesus Christ, this is. It's wild. Jesus! It says what? You got two former brothers going at it. You got the former champ and the current champ battling out. God damn it. Is Sean going to leave? WCF, or is he going to be in? The triple threat match. God damn it, get out of here for my own team. This is getting scary. My God, he's got him choked out.